Hi, Barry Young here. Today we're going to grind some tool bits for your lathe out of high-speed blanks. This is actually a high-speed tool bit. It's 1-inch square. You probably won't be using anything this big, but it really makes it easy for you to see what I'm doing. I'm actually going to grind a smaller one because this takes forever to grind. I know your time is valuable. So, I've labeled the faces of this tool. Face one, face two, and face three. Face one is the end of the tool bit, and it's a compound angle. Face two is a regular angle, that's the side rake. The top rake, face three, is also a regular angle. So let's knock that compound angle out first. Step to the side and start the grinder, because it's dangerous. Just in case. Now, first thing I'm going to do is turn the tool flat on the tool rest and just grind this away. Now, I'm going to turn this blue because I'm grinding it way too fast. When you do this in your workshop, you'll want to grind less pressure and more dunking. Okay, we've got a 5 to 7 degree angle on the end of this tool bit. Now this is mild steel, so it ground a little easier than what you're going to grind. And I'm also using the fine wheel on my grinder, which is on the left side. Cores are almost always on the right. I'm using this mild steel so it'll go quicker. Alright, now we've got the end angle, but it's not a compound angle, it's just flat right now. I'm going to lower the end in my right hand and raise the tip a little bit, like this, to grind that compound angle. Now you notice how I went straight into the wheel to match the angle that I'd ground before, and then raised the tip? Okay, ouch, that's hot. So, again, this is turning colors because I'm grinding it way too fast to save time on this video so that you can get back to the football game. As soon as the sparks start coming off the top of the tool, instead of going underneath it, I know I've reached the top. And sure enough, I have. Right here, this grind has gone all the way to the top of the tool. And it got rather warm. For the second face, face two, the side rake, I'm going to turn the tool 90 degrees and then I'm going to rotate it back towards me about 3 degrees, which is in the beginning pretty tough to accomplish, but you'll get used to it the more tools you grind. I like to grind back just about 1.5 times as far as the thickness of the tool. Just go straight in. Don't forget to dunk. Ouch! Now, if you look right here, one of your goals is to make that grind parallel. The top of that grind should be parallel with the top of the tool. Easier said than done. Practice, practice, practice. Once again, we're going to grind until the sparks come off the top of the tool, which means that the angle we're grinding has reached the top of the tool. Some of these tool bits have a slight radius on them, the older ones. The newer ones tend to be ground all over and don't, so they're easier to grind. I'm starting to see sparks. So I am all the way. Now, one thing that we want to do is try and make one solid continuous grind from top to bottom. This particular one has got two facets. We're going to keep grinding until those facets go away. Trying to hold the bit steady as long as you can without burning yourself, and that will make it one continuous grind. One more time. You can feel when the tool, one more time. You can feel when the tool flattens itself on the wheel. That means that you've matched all the cuts you've made before. Now we have one continuous grind top to bottom. Beautiful. The last grind that we need to do is on the top of the tool, called the top rake. To do that, we go on the other side of the wheel, 90 degrees, tilt it back, and plunge. This is going to be a 2 to 4 degree angle because I'm cutting a really hard material today, 4140, and I need as much cutter left as I can get. Once again, let's take a peek right here. Notice how the distance from my grind to the top of the tool, I'm sorry, to the side of the tool, is greater at the root than it is out here at the tip. That means that I had this end elevated a little bit, and I need to straighten it back out and get it truly horizontal, which I'll do right now. And there we are. One continuous grind all the way without digging into the tool. This leading edge is the cutting edge. And we now have a good tool, except for a few little touch-ups, burrs that I have to get off, and the radius. How in the heck do we get a radius on there? What I do is I look at the side and match the angle on the front of the tool to the angle of the wheel. And then I walk it around the corner of the wheel. Like that. And the goal is to get the width of this radius equal on the top and the bottom. You'll notice that mine is just a little bit narrow at the bottom. So I'm going to go back in till it hits flat, and then I'm going to lower the shank just a little bit. And that should make my radius equal in width top to bottom. And that's definitely good enough. This tool will cut after I get the burrs removed, which I can do very easily by a super light grind on each face that I did before. Now, before I use this, I would hit it with an easy lap diamond hone to remove any little tiny burrs that I can't see. And that's how we make a right hand turning tool. Just change the angles exactly opposite of these angles to make a left-hand turning tool. Thank you.